Good morning, everyone. Another vlog here. I'm on my way to a class 2 shift. Okay, nice and early. It's currently 6:30 in the morning. Sorry, tell a lie. It's 6:40 in the morning. I live about half hour away from the depot, so not too bad. I got everything I need for today. Golden rule of three. Yeah, driver's license, driver CPC card, and the tachograph, okay? Never forget any of those three, otherwise you're in, you know, kind of a big bit of trouble, to be honest, because you don't want to be getting caught out with without any of those. So yeah, got my my magic three cards in my bag, got my lunch, got everything I need, and it is absolutely freezing, so I bought some gloves and all sorts of stuff just in case. But yeah, nice and easy class two work, nice and sunny. It should be a good quick day, about 7 hours, 8 hour shift, I reckon. Yeah, doing a bit of multi-drop, pallets in the back with the palletizer, offloading to maybe Waitrose again, not 100% sure, we shall see. So yeah, off to the depot I go. Made it to the depot, okay. In fact, it was actually quite funny because I don't think they realized I was going to do a proper rigid first parade or walk around check, which obviously I was. And I obviously got in this small kind of class one that I'm driving now, this Volvo, and I had to look for a minute there, I didn't know what I was driving. Yeah, it's a Volvo, really small class two lorry. Yeah, I got in it and started doing my walkabout check, and even before I got into it, to be honest, I started realizing that it was leaning off to like the right a bit, and I thought, no, that can't be right. So I looked at the axle at the back of both tires, and they were already touching. There was that much weight on that one axle at the back that it was causing the rear tires to touch. So that's the first one for me. Obviously, usually these guys are amazing at loading. You know, this company has people that load it overnight, and everything's always been good to go, as I was explained. Obviously, everyone's human. Someone's loaded every single case of wine that's in the back of this truck on the same axle, causing an overload there. So yeah, thankfully, before I left, I basically just said to them, look, I'm not taking that anywhere. You know, that needs to get sorted before I drive it off. So they've had to swap my my deliveries around, which is quite annoying, because now I'm gonna have to go and deliver drop number two, will have to be delivered as drop number one, and then drop number two will have to be number one. You get the picture, okay? I'm gonna have to swap those around. It's quite annoying, to be fair. So yeah, that's something that can happen, I guess. First one for me, being a newbie to all this, I thought, yeah, we'll be good to go, do a little first parade, do a little walk around. Nothing too crazy. Will be you know, fairly good truck, as they always are. And lo and behold, yeah, completely overloaded on the rear axle. So I started at 7 this morning, and what time is it now? It's 9:15 or 8:50. So I've almost spent 2 hours sorting out this fucking situation for them to obviously swap around the deliveries, as well as get someone to get the pallets moved about and jigged around so that it doesn't overload. Thankfully they got that done, and I had to obviously redo my walk around checks and all that good stuff. So yeah, it's going to be a long day, because I haven't even gotten started, really. I've only just left, and I don't get to my first one until 10 o'clock. So yeah, obviously I can work up to 6 hours, providing I don't go over my 4.5 of driving. Yeah, obviously keeping that in mind, it doesn't leave me too much room to crack on with my deliveries now. So I was going to try and get two done, and then I'll probably have to pull over and have like a half hour break. But it's looking like by the time I get there and they offload me and I get all the signatures and I do all the curtains back up and that, you know, I'm looking to approach the 5 hour mark, and I don't really risk it. When it gets to about the 5 hour mark, that's it. Like, I'm looking for a place to stop. Anyway, side of the road, lay by. I don't care where, I've always got my food with me and like my drinks and stuff. My only situation is obviously being somewhere in city centre, somewhere busy, and then you've got to stop. So, you know, my advice would be never to leave it that close. About 5.5 hours, quite, it's pushing it a little bit. But like I said, yeah, I like to take the most. That's something that I actually struggle to come to terms with, actually. Like, the working hours directive and your driving hours mixed all into one is quite a hard thing to grasp initially. So I'll talk a little bit about kind of my experience with it. So firstly, maximum of 6 hours you can work, driving and working. Your tachograph usually changes as and when. So if you're sitting on this chair for longer than 5 minutes, you know, it'll class it as driving, some of them. Or if you're, you know, driving for like 5 minutes, it'll automatically switch to driving. So, you know, you don't really have to worry about changing it. You just have to worry about two things: taking a break, a half hour break before your 6 hour point, okay, and taking a half hour break, or a 45 minute break even, if you're reaching the 4.5 hour driving time. So right now, for instance, I started at 7 in the morning. I know I'm not going to drive 4.5 hours solid. I know I'm going to be mixing driving a couple hours with working a couple hours. So as long as I keep my eye on the driving side, okay, I know that I'll need a break at my 6 hour period, because there's no way I'm going over 4.5 hours of driving. Well, I see a coach, that's a good sign. Right, there's Waitrose, but where the hell is their delivery? Oh look, there we go. Nice and easy. Things you like to see. Straight away, deliveries in here. But I haven't got a clue if people reversing or what. Yeah, by the looks of it, they do.
It's my first time here, mate.
Yeah, no, I saw it. I was like, oh, poor bloke.
Fuming. Yeah, well, this agency shift, so this is my first time doing this. But when I came from that side.
Yeah.
So obviously, I had to. Yeah. Problem. Finally arrived at my third drop off. Okay, 3 out of 4 today, so not too many, but some weird places, some faraway areas, some weird business kind of complexes, which means that it took quite a long time to find the individual company that wanted these pallets and so forth. Not just the typical Waitrose delivery and supermarket delivery, even though funnily enough this one is Waitrose, but that's besides the point. The first one was Waitrose as well, actually, and as you've probably seen from that video, turning around was a bitch, okay? Just because their little platform's broken, usually you drive on there, by the looks of it, and their whole floor rotates and turns, does a full 360. So usually you just drive in, plop your vehicle on, get someone to come out, and they'll spin you 360, and you start offloading using the tail lift. However, that was broken, so I had to do like a 25 point turn, as you'll see from the video. Be sure to enjoy that, because that sucks for me. Anyway, got it done, didn't hit anything, brilliant, always a bonus. Job number two, that sucked as well, okay. It was the most overloaded pallets filled with wine cases that it just became a little bit dangerous at some points to offload it using the tail lift and stuff like that. And it was, bless them, it was this old couple that had obviously started up this own business. So I kind of did everything and a bit above and beyond, but Jesus Christ, like some of these pallets are just loaded beyond the way that one person can manage. So definitely watch out for those. Now I'm gonna start my third delivery. And I'll film it from a different angle so you guys can see what an offload looks like. It's a nice small Waitrose in a welcome break just off the A34 near Oxford. By the way, top geezer, Arthur, I think his name is, from Waitrose, gave us donuts for free, okay? Because he knew I was having a half hour break and he was like, do you know what, do you want to take these on your break? And obviously I'm gonna say yes, who wouldn't? A few Krispy Kremes on the way back, I think. Cheers for that. Anyway, let's get into it, unless I offload this pallet. Unfortunately, had a proper look at the paperwork as this guy was signing it. And I was thinking to myself, you know what? I've actually got like another 5-6 pallets. Like, what's going on? And then I realized that there's another page. And in that other page, there's another 3 drops. So this has now gone from a couple hour shift, 6-7 hour shift to probably a 12, maybe even 13. Because the addresses on the other ones are quite far away. Bloody hell, not a lot of room here to turn. Oh, I'm gonna have to take a shunt. Boom, just like that. Okay. So yeah, I've got Wells to go. Just done that quick delivery there at Waitrose. Cheers for the donuts, I guess. Had a nice little half hour break as well. It was actually 35 minutes, but do you know what I mean? This is why this job, or driving jobs in general, HEV, the whole industry, it's quite a good gig because there's no real pressure, do you know what I mean? Yes, you've got to deliver them, you know, at a certain time and stuff like that, but not really. Like, there's so many things that can go wrong. There's so many vehicle defects, for instance, like the incident this morning where I was overloaded. Like, so many things can happen. So most companies, especially for agency drivers, don't really mind what time frame you do it in. They will just, as long as you do the job you're meant to do and deliver all of them to where they're meant to go within, you know, before the place is closed, you should be fine. And they allow plenty of room for fuck ups anyway, because they know everyone's human. Do you know what I mean? Anything could happen. You could break down, or you could whatever. So they're not stupid, and they give plenty of advance. Yeah, they give you plenty of notice in advance to obviously have enough time for fuck ups if they happen. So yeah. Good thing is as well, the next delivery's another like four pallets even of just wine. Literally all 4 pallets are just wine, which is good. I've been wanting to get rid of those because I've been driving like an absolute granny until I get rid of those, you know what I mean? I don't want to be that guy that tipped over the wine. Even though it's strapped fairly well and it weighs enough and it's bandaged in a certain way, so it's pretty safe anyway, but you never want to take that risk, do you know what I mean? So I shall leave it. I shall be driving this very, very slowly and easy until I drop off this wine. So on my taco card, I've got 2 hours and 29 minutes until I need a 45 minute break, as I'll have reached my my 4.5 hours of driving. So although I took a half hour break, that was because of the 6 hours that I've been working, driving accumulated with work. Now that I'm gonna, in 2 hours and a half, I'm gonna be coming up to the 4.5 hour benchmark of driving, I will need a 45 minute break. And then after that, I should be good for another few hours. Okay, obviously taking into account the max driving allowed is 10 hours and the max working and driving mixed is 15 hour days. So yeah, as long as I'm not doing 15 hours or over, I'm good. And to be honest, I won't be anyway. This will probably be maybe, I don't know, 11 hour shift, 12 hour shift. I have to say, at the moment, I'm really enjoying doing this. Like, I don't do it often anyway. Like, it's only maybe one or twice a week. And that's like maybe every other week. So sometimes I might only drive 4 or 5 times a month at most. But that's enough to generate, you know, £600-700 after deductions, after the 20% tax and that. It starts adding up, man. And to be honest, I really enjoy getting out there, doing the different jobs, different experiences. And obviously, who doesn't like an extra £500-600 at the end of the month? Or weekly, really, because you get paid weekly, but I just put it away for the whole month. So yeah, and aside from that, one thing to really enjoy is there's no interaction with anyone. Like, you go pick up your truck, you get in your truck, and you crack on. There's no one watching you, there's no one doing anything. Like, it's just you, the vehicle, your sat nav, and a bunch of deliveries that you have to make. And that's just multi-drop. Do you know what I mean? If you're doing some other work, or shall I say easier work, where you just have to go to a depot and reverse up and they do all the offloading, just one depot, there and back, you're laughing. But I do find when you're doing multi-drop, Jesus Christ, does time go quick. Like, you genuinely don't even realize how fast time's going by and how quickly, you know, you're working. You drive an hour and a half here, you spend an hour offloading, doing all your bits and bobs, another 2 hours driving up north, offload, an hour and a half, break. And you can break whenever, like, just because it says you have to take a half hour break at the 6 hour point or before the 6 hour point, doesn't mean you can pull over, stretch your legs for 15 minutes, you know, drive an hour, do the exact same thing. Like, there's no one breathing on top of you, there's no pressure, you just crack on. So I've got to say, because of that, I'm really enjoying things at the minute with this. The money's great, the experience is great. I love creating content and giving everyone else kind of an insight into what it's like. So that's also great. And to anyone else that's kind of wanting to do this, I would really urge yourselves to have a look and really find out why you'd want to do this. Like, why you want to vlog, why you want to YouTube. For me, it's personal satisfaction. I love editing. I love filming things. I've always wanted to do it, but I've just never had the confidence to go, do you know what, I'm gonna start doing it. And a while back, I just thought, do you know what? There's so many people out there in my position who are just starting on their careers or thinking about going into this industry who would like to know things like I did. Do you know what I mean? I would like to have someone to look at their videos and stuff like that and get a bit of experience, a bit of visual experience before the jobs, because agencies and certain jobs, they don't care. As long as you're qualified, guess what? You're gonna get given a vehicle docs, your manifest, you know, what you're delivering and where you're delivering to, and your time and address, and there's the keys, see you later. So having these videos, having these people that regularly do vlogs on HGVs and stuff is an absolute goldmine to anyone looking into the, you know, this type of work. Anything, any problems you're gonna come and face, we've already experienced it. Any, you know, any issues or anything that you wanna see day-to-day life footage,
we've got you. Like, it's really, really useful for people like myself. I even use it still. I love watching other people's vlogs and stuff and seeing different vehicles, seeing what they get up to, what type of jobs there are, what they find to be, you know, a really good company or what they don't find to be. And it just gives you an idea of, okay, do you know what? I see myself doing that. Let's go for it. And to anyone that's looking to get into this industry, crack on. It's the best industry to have zero qualifications. You literally need zero GCSEs, zero college, zero apprenticeships, nothing. All you need, okay, is to do the licenses. Once you do your licenses, your C, your C plus E, okay? Once you do that and the theory test and your CPC module, you're done. That's new. That's now you qualified, okay, to now start earning, you know, 40, 45 grand a year. If you want to put the hours in, you can do it easily. So I honestly think it's the best industry for people with no quals, no real education, no nothing needed. You just get a couple of licenses and crack on. One thing I will say about this, you have to be shit hot with your driver's hours. Like, you get complacent or you start taking breaks 5 minutes after the cutoff time or anything like that, and you get caught, that's a lot of money and a lot of hassle that you do not need. You can get prosecuted, you can get fines, you can get your license taken off you, and that's game over. So it has its risks. Also, if you get caught speeding in a civilian car, fair enough, whatever, 6 points, 7 points, 8 points, that's fine. But if you get caught speeding and you drive HGVs for a living, again, that's more risks. So there are pros and there are cons. And I feel like that's definitely one of the cons. Is you have to be a professional at all times, even in your normal cars. Because one slip up, you get caught doing 95 or something stupid like that, and it's over. So it can be rewarding and it has its risks.